biggest, biggest reason I would never want to have a kid because I will never again on my own or even assist on installing a car seat. I don't know how many of you have ever had to do this, but if you're gonna, here's a few helpful hints. Take the whole day off work because that's how long it's gonna take you. Whatever your favorite alcohol is, have a bucket of it next to that minivan because you're going to stop and have to take drinks and reread things. If you're over the age of, oh, I'd say 30, at some point you're going to become infuriated with Ralph Nader because he's the one who started it all. I remember being in grade school and he was on 60 Minutes. Seatbelts, everybody must have a seatbelt. Car seat, seatbelt, safety is for life. Head injuries are also for life. I have statistics. Well, maybe you do, Ralph. I'm sure you do, but so do I. There were 7 of us, Ralph. For 16 years, we rode around in the back of a station wagon completely untethered. Completely. And we were in accidents, a lot of them, especially if my mom was driving. Sometimes we got hit so hard, I actually flew to a better seat than I had originally secured. Who's got the window now? That's right. And that was with my parents chain smoking in the car. Both of them. It was so smoky in that car. You could barely see other passengers, seriously. The way, way back was like Studio 54 because the sun would hit the smoke and create patterns, and then I would draw patterns within the pattern. Because I didn't have an iPad, so that's what I would do to entertain myself. If you're a woman and you're gonna install a car seat, I would highly suggest you put on a sports bra, because you're gonna get hot. You're gonna be so hot, you're gonna start inadvertently just tearing off pieces of clothing. And if you're not careful, you'll end up like I did in my sister's driveway in my regular bra, just drinking a beer, staring off into space. And the normally very friendly neighbors came home trying to talk to him, but I don't know why they're being so weird. And I'm like, how you guys doing? Yeah, no, I just came home, she had twins. I gotta do 2 of these. I can't figure it out. I'm so hot. So hot. I would offer you a beer, but I only have 3 left. And I've made no progress. So I just found notes on the back of there's factory notes that say if you don't know how to do this, you can take it to the police department or the fire department and they'll install it for you. But unfortunately, I didn't find those notes till after I'd already started drinking. So I don't think it would be a good idea to drive 2 law enforcement and 2 car seats, and I don't even have any babies. I mean, it's just too much to explain, right? That's crazy. So this is what I was thinking. I was thinking I might set her car on fire. I'll call the fire department. And then after they put the car out, I go, hey, since you're all here, think you can give me a hookup? They're a pain in the ass, too, to put kids in them, especially in winter with the coats and 70,000 buckles and the whole thing. And the one, my brother's kid, I thought was big enough to not go in a car seat. And I said, do I got to do him, too? And she's just disgusted with my lack of any parenting knowledge. She goes, oh, 4'10", 80 pounds. What? That's Missouri state law, Kathleen. If you're 4'10" or shorter, 80 pounds or less, you're in a car seat versus a ticket from the Missouri State Highway Patrol. I go, really, 4'10"? That is excellent news, because right now, I'm only 5'1". The average woman, due to osteoporosis, in your life, you will have shrunk anywhere from 2 to 5 inches. I am not certain, I am bad at math, but I'm pretty sure that puts me back in a car seat. I can't wait to be back in a car seat. All these nieces and nephews I have will be old enough to drive. And I'm going to do exactly what they do. I'm going to call them, say I need a ride, and then I'm going to pack a big bag full of unnecessary, unrelated items that I have to have, or there is going to be a meltdown. Then, like the 5- and 6-year-olds, I'm going to get in the van and walk on my own accord to the very back seat, and I'm just going to hop up in it like they do and wait for the great buckling. Just sit there. And I'm going to let them buckle me in. Then I'm going to let them pull away. And I'm going to wait till they drive where it's somewhere terribly inconvenient to pull over. And I'm going to start screaming from the back like they do. My buckle's too tight. I'm joking. I dropped my wine.